crumble.
Nonsense. There's never been a threat.
Squad.
Couldn't handle.
It is the purpose of the
squad
to align our infamous forces against the powers of good and defeat them, leaving us the rulers of the world.
Are you ready? Are you ready? It's your girl. Miss Spicy, host of Spicy Conversations. Join me every Thursday night.
Every Thursday night
at 9 p.m. Eastern on Spreaker.com for some late night talk. I hope you're ready.
You're ready.
Spicy Conversations.
This is the number one Chief Rock of Jersey, Vern. When I wake up on a Saturday morning, all I want to do is turn into my main man. They're kicking it with the Kysii show, man, because Kysii is going to bring you something that you really don't know what's coming, but when it hits you, you feel like you've been educated and you feel more of a good vibe within yourself, because Kysii keep doing what he do. They're kicking it with the Kysii show. Do that thing, Kysii. One love, my brother.
All right. We are back from our break and we're still kicking it with Kysii Show. Found live right now on the WSME network, found at WSMEradio.com, also simulcast at Kysii.com. And in case you know you did not have any idea what this is
a squad.
Yeah, so the main thing is I actually have formulated a nice form of group of people here, and that's my girl VJ Burton, my man Shane G.
Hi.
VJ is one half of the Choppin' It Up with Q podcast, and my man Shane G is the other half of the Midwest Coast podcast. So we put together this little show today that we're gonna do. I like bringing in all kind of different opinions and minds, and I just shuffle it up, man. And I say, okay, this will be a very entertaining show, and it has been thus far. So thank y'all for everybody that's been tuning in thus far, man. Y'all just hit the first half of it. We got another half to go, so we got a lot more information. So if you're listening to me on Kysii.com, or listening to me on the Kicking It with Kysii mobile app, or if you listen to me on TuneIn Radio, iHeartRadio, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, wherever it is, thank you for tuning in. And if you're on Spreaker, be sure to join in. Hit the chat bubbles and you can actually join this live interaction that's going on, because we've got a live chat room going as we speak right now. And shout out to my man Zelania, the Wait a Minute show is up, who's up in here. He's also another X-Squad affiliate. You can find him 8 p.m. on Saturday nights, rocking. That's 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Saturday nights. And he's also on the WSME network as well on Wednesday evenings, I think around 8 o'clock, 8:30 mark as well.
Or maybe it's 9 o'clock.
I have to figure that out. I don't know, man. I never really know. So many times, so many different things, so many shows I listen to, man. All day, every day, I'm listening to so many shows, so many X-Squad affiliate shows, so many Pod Squad shows. I'm like, man, my wife is like, yo, when are you going to come upstairs and spend time with me? I'm like, I'm just finishing up this show real quick. But listen. I know when to turn it off. I just catch it, you know, the next day or the morning, whatever time I got to. But sometimes you got to put that balance in it, man. We got too many shows, man. Sometimes it's hard to catch everybody. And I'm like, listen, if y'all can, please listen to everybody's show. Please comment, like, share, whatever. They'll appreciate it. You know, sometimes I don't get to hear everybody's full shows. I try my best. But, man, portfolio of shows is growing so big. It's absolutely crazy. Yeah, y'all know what I'm talking about. Anyway, we were just talking about the whipping, and y'all had me laughing over the break because we was continuing on with that conversation, and DJ, you were talking about, I think you just said you only dated one man that had a child. And you said
that is right.
At some point in time, you had to drop him because he wasn't being responsible with that child.
Well, I mean, he didn't have custody ever, but I just feel like if you have a child, why wouldn't you want to spend as much time with your child as you can? I get it. You have a job. Their mom probably has a job. Custody arrangement, because I asked, because obviously things are different. Some people have custody arrangements where they only see their kids on specific days or specific weekends. But I asked, and he was like, no, we don't have any type of arrangement in place. I can see her whenever I want.
So,
but you're here with me every weekend. So.
Oh, he never made. I got you. Uh huh.
And they lived and he lived in the same city as his daughter. So I was just like, what's the real story, Wishbone? What is really going on?
Well, what it was, he was trying to make you another baby mama and had that same situation. So you was like, you saw all the way through that.
Oh, no. My birth control just works so well. It is just so fantastic. That is why I'm 31 years old with no babies. Because you know what? Hey-o. You're not about to. Obviously, your pullout game is weak if you already got kids. So what does that say for me? No. Nope, pull out game horrible, but I'm supposed to let you know.
She like nope, it ain't going on like that. Shout out my man Gary G Money up in
I
here.
Use that.
Real Cash Ranger. Yes. let me keep moving on with topics, man. We got so many we be going through, man. I had to get to the next one. All right. The rise of side chicks. Is it now acceptable? You know what? I don't understand.
I don't think it's acceptable now. I think we just have a name for it now.
Yeah, we got a name for it.
Before it was like, you know what I'm saying? Whereas before it was like mistress, but you had to be married to have a mistress. You know what I'm saying? Whereas if you had like a main girlfriend and then another girlfriend, you was just cheating. You know what I'm saying? Like that's just what it was. Now we got names for it, so that makes it seem like it's more acceptable, but of course not. Like, nobody's, you know what I mean? Like, most people, I'm not going to say nobody, because some people like that role, you know what I mean? So that, because there's less responsibility with it, less attachment, all that kind of stuff. So some people like that role, but for the most part, I don't think anybody's just going to willingly put up with being on the side, you know what I'm saying? Dudes or chicks.
Go ahead.
That I don't know about that. I had an aunt that once told me, honestly, that being somebody's side chick is the best thing you can be because you get all the girlfriend perks, but you don't have to live with him. You don't have to go through his problems. You don't have to wash his underwear. You don't have to make sure he eats. None of that. If you choose to, great, but you don't have to. And then when he gets tired of your shit or you get tired of his, you can just quit seeing him.
See, that's what I'm saying. So for some people, I feel like they like that better, you know what I mean? I just don't think that's the majority of people.
And see,
well, my aunt was crazy and kind of a drunk, so you shouldn't really. Well, don't go by that.
What I don't understand is because this is a new world, so it's hard to have a side chick or even a side family. You know what I'm saying? Just remember, okay, back in the day, people had whole families down the street. Like he had the side chick plus the kids, some other whole other family down the street. But now. You got Facebook, you got all that. You can't do that now. People done put your shit on blast so fast, you know what I'm saying? It's not going to happen. You know what I'm saying? There's no way that can happen nowadays. But you have whole families that might be less than 8 miles away and got away with it. It's crazy.
Well, here's the thing about it. I also think it has to do a lot with the way relationships have changed. Because when you look at it, a lot of times that in those situations, those people are married, right? You're married and you have a family. This person steps outside and has out of your marriage, has another family on the side. But do you leave? Do you leave? I mean, a lot of people stay together, right? Regardless of whatever, side babies, whatever else. People's marriages stay together. So you could have a completely different family on the side that wasn't spoken about. Your wife may know about these people, but she wasn't going to say anything because what does that look like to everybody else?
That's true.
So it might have been knowledge within your family, but then you don't, you know, you don't say anything. It's an accepted part that you don't talk about of keeping your marriage together.
That's true.
And then not only that, I agree with all of that. And then I think another thing that happens also is, because you got to think back in the day, women weren't in the workforce as much. Most women were, you know, stay-at-home moms, stay-at-home wives, things like that. So now that women are out in the workforce and they're meeting people and they're developing their own social lives and all that kind of stuff, you know, this has been going on for a long time, or not a long time, but for a while now, you know what I mean? So I think that since women just are out in public more, out in the world more than they were, they're going to have more information, they're going to know more people, they're going to find more stuff out. Whereas back in the day, if you're a woman and your only places that you went to was church and the grocery store, and that was it, you know what I mean? Who do you know outside of who your husband introduces you to? So how else are you going to find out, unless it's like neighborhood rumors, and in which case then it's like, okay, do I believe it or not? Like, there's never really any proof back in the day. Whereas now somebody can take a picture of you right now and send it to everybody in 30 seconds.
That's right.
And you can't deny nothing. Oh, yeah, and then you know what I mean?
It's resources as well, right? Like, you're talking about women being outside of the home. It's resources. Like, I might be pissed off to within an inch of my life that you got this side baby and brought it home or got a family up the street. But I don't have any money or resources to leave. So I might be real mad, but where am I going to go?
Now, that's interesting. Yeah, you're a house lady, housewife. Ain't got no job. Yeah, that makes sense.
I mean, it's the same thing now. You have people that are in relationships where they're not the primary breadwinner. So they may want to leave. That person may be getting on their nerves, and they may be trying to formulate a plan to leave. But it's a lot of people that stay in relationships until they can put back the appropriate amount of money to leave the person and be in a position where they're not homeless or whatever.
Yeah.
I mean, because look at how many... The cost of living is expensive. Like, shit, think of how many people are in relationships where they broke up and they still have to live together until the lease is up so they can move. How many times have you heard that story?
I was just going to say, I know somebody who I used to work with, and she had a baby with this dude or whatever, and she was just like, you know what, he's been cheating on me, and he's been doing this, he's been doing that. Like, I'm leaving him. Like, and I'm like, yo, like, that probably sounds like the best thing. You know what I'm saying? If you're not happy, like, you know, do what you got to do or whatever. Like, that next week, she was like, yeah, so I found out I'm pregnant. I'm not going nowhere. I was like, wow. All right. Like, she was like, I mean, what am I going to do now? Now I'm going to have two kids. Like, it was already going to be hard enough with just the one, but now I got two of this nigga's babies. I can't go nowhere. I'm like, yep, he trapped you. That's the male trap.
Wow.
Oh, Jesus. I don't want any. I'm good. Oh, Lord. I didn't even know that was a thing. That's what you do? That's what they're out here doing?
So, this might sound offensive, and I apologize in advance to any of my Latino or Hispanic listeners, especially if you are in Arizona listening right now. I have a thing that I call the Mexican hat trick. And what that is three babies, right? And I've seen it everywhere. Like, this is why I've come up with it. Because this is what I've seen, like, with very attractive Latina women out here. They're either pregnant, they have a small child, and they're pregnant with the second, or they have two small children, and they're pregnant with the third. It never fails. It doesn't matter where I'm at. If I'm in the mall, if I'm just out in the streets, it doesn't matter. If you're attractive, you got two with one on the way. Like, it's just consistent. And so I call it the Mexican hat trick. I'm like, oh, this is your way of making sure that nobody else dates your woman, because, you know what I mean? Like, you make her a lot less dateable if she's got three kids. You know what I'm saying? It just is what it is. I'm sorry. But you make her less dateable if she's got three. If you got one, you can work with that. If you got two, maybe. Three, that's a bit much. So dudes know. They're like, yeah, she ain't going nowhere if I give her three real quick back to back.
Wow. I'm sorry.
Wow, wow, wow.
Oh my God.
Yo, that works. VJ, you trying to know.
And I don't see it with nobody else. I don't see it with nobody else. That's why I call it the Mexican hat trick.
Wow.
I mean, but that's a
Shout out to my Mexican family members, though. You know, I love y'all. I got actual cousins. Mexican, so it ain't like that.
Oh, shit. I mean, but that's a valid